what's up, guys? Rossi here, coming from you at the floor in Vegas, SHOT Show 2023. And this is exciting because a year ago, we made our way down here and kind of stumbled upon Bill and his team. Here's Bill Gardner with Skout Airguns. No idea who they were, what they were, and he starts taking us to a video, and all of you saw it, you watched it, and everyone got super excited about what they were talking about, what was coming. They said it was going to be ready this year. Boom.
It's ready.
It's here. It's shipping. Yep. It's out there. Take me through it. First of all, look at these guns. I mean, gorgeous. Come on. Like, look at, like, out of the gate, I'm like, all right. Physically, you've already got me. Like, physically, I'm attracted. I like what I'm seeing. I'm looking at barrels. I'm looking at liners. I'm looking at moderators. I mean, like, right? Just, you walk by, you're like, this looks interesting. And this isn't, that's right, Bill? This doesn't even, the real deal is the gun.
It is.
That's where the real excitement
there's
is.
There's a lot of things I couldn't show you last year that I could show you this year.
Well, let just start me from the beginning, right, and let's work our way through it.
All right. The most interesting part of the gun, and I think the thing that everyone's most interested in, is how it works. And this is the valve. This is everything. And basically, this is a 400,000th orifice, which is huge for an air gun. If you tried to close a 4,000th orifice in a standard air gun, you'd need a sledgehammer to get it open.
Okay.
But what we're doing is we're using pressures against each other, so we're balancing this valve so it doesn't require as much energy to open. And the way it works is a small burst of air shoots right between these two surfaces right here.
Okay.
And pulls the valve 45,000ths off its seat. Then the pressure from firing the pellet goes down through a small orifice and works on this massive surface to slam the valve shut. So okay, it allows for adjustment of the gun from 177 sub 12 pounds all the way up to 150 foot pounds without having to change hammers, springs, and to get a very crisp action, meaning not a dwelly. Many times when you're trying to shoot slugs, okay, in certain air rifles, you need to add hammers and springs and systems.
Right, because you need more oomph,
right,
to push a heavier projectile.
Because of the way this works, as this pressure builds, we get more and more shutting force. The trick to an air rifle is get it open quickly and get it shut quickly.
Sure.
And this allows us to do that across all pressure ranges, which is really unique.
It is very unique.
And also,
and no one ever shows their valve, by the way. You cannot go to any other area, yeah,
right,
and they're like, look at our valve. Like, right, you're showing exactly
and
what
another
we're
thing
at.
That a lot of customers are going to like is getting into this valve. So many air rifles can take 20, 25 minutes to get into their valve, and you have to be very careful as you go. We take out three screws in this body, pull the body apart, and then there's four screws at the end of this chamber right here.
Yeah.
And we're into the valve in 3 minutes or less.
Wow.
And then from the standpoint of a tool, there's a special tool. You come in on this hex, pull the valve out,
yep,
replace the valve. Everything is made in cartridge replacements. This is where replace this whole thing, get up and go.
Okay.
Also on our regulators, there's two regulators in the gun. This is the high pressure regulator, which regulates the pressure into the plenum chamber and is unique because you can turn it in both directions. You don't have to degas the gun.
Okay.
But this is a whole module. Basically, if you take this off, take the spring kit out, there's a hex built into this.
Yeah.
And you can just screw this. So you can take the old regulator out, screw the new regulator in
and
a minute, ready to go. So, you know, we're trying to make it for the dealers.
What?
So it's really easy to use.
Okay.
And that's the same thing with our low pressure regulator. This is the regulator that controls the amount of pressure to the solid oil. Very, very, same thing, modular, pops in and out.
So screw it either way at any point,
yep,
in between shots, and everything just,
yep, right,
keeps moving, makes the adjustments, and keeps shooting.
Right. In fact, the tune on the gun is much easier. Generally speaking, you don't have to do much with this low pressure. Set it to about 150 pounds per square inch.
Yeah.
Then you're adjusting your velocity just with the high pressure and the dwell setting. So the electronics allows you to control 40 different settings, half milliseconds between setting, to how long the solenoid stays open to open the valve. So the tuning is much simpler than most guns.
Yeah. It sounds complicated, but if you've ever taken apart an air gun, this sounds a lot easier.
It is easy.
The biggest thing about what you've done with that inside, it allows you to get more speed using less air, correct?
That and reliability. So because,
okay,
you only have one part moving 45 thousandths of an inch.
Yeah.
There's no sears to wear.
Right.
There's, you know, when you've got an air rifle.
You've taken O-rings out of the equation.
Exactly. Many, many O-rings have been taken out. So basically, when you get an air rifle, standard air rifle, and you keep using it, it's changing a lot as you're using it. Because you're wearing your sear, your tune changes a little bit. You've got to tweak a lot.
Yeah.
With this, there's very little that changes. And most of the tuning is controlled by electronics, which allow a much finer level of tuning.
Sure.
So it's just simpler. Simpler things usually work better.
Okay. But just an electronic trigger. I mean, right, for the most part. Yep. It's a mechanical gun.
Correct.
You don't have to really worry about, because I know a lot of people get out there, they hear electronic, they think, ah, mm-hmm. I got to charge the gun.
Right.
I'm going to forget to, like, take me through it. Why is this a more simple process?
Well, first of all, we have 30 years of manufacturing paintball guns. And paintball players are much more abusive to their guns than air gunners. They
sure.
jump in puddles. At times, we had to show these boards underwater, firing, pulling
oh, wow.
them out. You know,
yeah.
we've done this for many times.
Okay.
But basically, the real neat thing about this is the trigger pull is nothing. It's grams. And it'll, so.
Like that's it?
That's it.
That's
so, that's it.
Wow.
So, and what makes it safe is you have to hit this actuator switch before you can fire.
Okay.
It also has a sensor. So when the bolt is, see how the bolt closed?
Yeah.
That little circle. Now if I open it, it goes open.
Okay.
So what it knows is whether you've put a pellet in.
Yeah.
So let's say you let's say that you go to try to fire it without closing it.
Yep.
Well, it won't fire.
So there's no accidental
exactly.
slam your bolt shut.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Which
stuff like that.
I've done that many times in competition.
And I guess
you miss it.
We'll start from the back forward,
yeah.
but we saw this last year to some extent. These are full machined out of aluminum billet. This is the 30 caliber. We do things a little differently in that we don't put a block in here. We want you to be able to. So on 30 caliber, I do two. That gives me the right tension.
Okay.
But if I had 117 and I did two, I'd crush the pellet. So with 117, we're only going to do about a turn and a quarter. So basically, you're able to have some. But on top of that, everything pops in place magnetically, and it's the actually it sucks itself right into position. So it.
If I
get it to the point, it'll just pull itself right in, okay? So that makes it align,
aligns
magnetically,
yep.
and you know, alignment.
Everything back here adjusts?
Yeah, everything is fully adjustable. You loosen the screws, and you can bring that. That's in, see? Bring that
okay.
right out. Very positive clicks.
Yep.
Lock it back down. You can also adjust this position, up, down.
Oh, wow, okay.
Positive clicks, very clean.
Yep.
Now, okay, as we move up, let's move to the barrel next. So there's a ratcheting system. It's maybe a little difficult to see here. This is what's on the other side. You see that knob?
Right here?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, so on this side of the gun, we're gonna push a button which pulls the ratchet away.
Okay.
And then we can pull this up and it unlocks the barrel. Okay, and now the barrel comes right out.
That's it?
That's it.
That's it.
Now I'll show you. There's a taper right here.
Okay.
And there's a matching taper in the transfer block. So basically, we're pulling those two, there's these two teeth right here, and we're pulling those two tapers together.
Snap right in.
Yep, and that's all there is to the barrel.
And then there's also a support
in the front here, multiple O-ring support that supports the front of the barrel as well.
And you can go from a 25-inch.
Right, to a 30, to different calibers. You still have to change your probe.
Yep.
That's very easy to access.
So, different barrel. What are the different barrel lengths?
There's 25 and 35.
25-inch
and 35, okay. Which is 625 millimeter and 998 millimeter.
Right.
If you want to do that.
Okay.
And let me show you what you get with it and how it works.
Okay.
So basically, every gun comes with three inserts. And these inserts are just as you see them here. There's a carbon liner on the outside, epoxied in place for rigidity.
Okay.
And then you have, it's engraved, you have a plus, a minus, and a zero. What that means is plus is a thousandth larger, minus is a thousandth smaller than zero, and then zero's in the middle.
Okay.
And this allows you to, another level of tune to sort of whatever pellet you're shooting.
Or slugs, you can go a little bit bigger.
A little smaller.
And caliber,
seen,
a little bit
we've
smaller.
We've seen a big difference in performance with that.
Because every gun likes a different pellet or different slug.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Got it.
You also get this moderator with every gun. And this moderator, it's a pretty nice moderator. There's a lot of ports. And we have the shredding. This is what you actually change for your caliber.
Okay.
So if you were, this is a 30 cal.
Yeah.
But you could put a 25 down to 117. Okay.
And then just use the same moderator.
Correct. That's how it works.
Okay. And so then, once you get one dialed in like this and it's amazing, you can keep it.
Yes.
Yeah.
And
got it.
We also have these angle ports that port down into the, so you're not just taking the extra gases into this.
Yeah.
You're also dumping them into the.
So it's coming in yeah. and around. Oh, okay.
And then this is also shredding the final amount of air off the pellet, so you don't get turbulence out the front of the barrel.
So super quiet.
Right. On top, people ask about indexing a barrel. Many
yeah.
people know what that is. Some don't. It's basically changing the position of the barrel.
Yeah.
And the way you index this, this is our little adjustment tighten down nut for the liner.
Okay.
And basically, there's a long barrel liner.
Yeah.
And there's a very tight O-ring fits on this front. So if I grab this and I just turn it a quarter turn,
yeah.
it now stays with the thread. So that quarter turn will maintain as I screw it back into the barrel. And therefore you can go ahead and index your barrels however you would want to index your barrels. Right. And to change out your caliber, you unscrew this piece
yeah.
as well, and then so this is a 30, you put a 25 in there, and then you change that piece I showed you inside the moderator,
yeah.
change your probe, and that's pretty much
and I can keep essentially the same barrels that I ordered originally.
Right. And basically, yeah, once you get the two sleeves, the 25 and the 30 inch carbon
yeah.
long sleeves, now you're buying just, you know, inserts, and you're not buying the whole thing anymore. You know,
sure.
you have your moderator, you're just buying, and of course that's less expensive.
Yeah.
Let's see.
So this gun can be 37 different guns.
It can be a lot. And the really unique thing is, when you bring that pressure up with that valve, you're getting a crisp shot, whether it be 177 or 35.
So from 177 to 35, I can use the same gun. I make the adjustments, and do you where do I get that information? Like, if I have a 177, I should change it. I put a 357 in there.
There's really not much to it.
Okay.
You put the 370 in it, and you adjust your regulator pressure up until you get your velocity. That's pretty much it.
And that's it.
Yeah. So it's not difficult.
Okay.
And then moving up to the electronics are housed inside the grip. The grip allows for palm swells for different size hands.
Sure.
The battery lasts ridiculous. This is the entire battery. It's a 4-volt system. 4 straight months of shooting. Tons of shots, 3 days a week. I'm not running out of battery. Okay?
Okay.
40-minute charge, and I'm back again.
What if it sits? How long can it sit?
Months.
Months?
Months.
Okay.
You know,
that's a fear, right? It's a, you yeah. go, you go to your case, you go to your whatever.
Right. Well,
you
if you really
out,
are
like,
concerned, you buy a second battery
and you're good
and
to
you
go.
Charge.
Fair
yeah. And they're lithium-ion battery. They're very reliable.
How does it charge?
You take off this palm swell here and this piece, and there's a USB charging port right
okay.
there.
Got it.
And that's basically it.
Okay.
So there are 3 nanometers, or the 3 gauges.
Yeah.
And what we're measuring is the chamber pressure, the tank pressure,
okay.
and the low pressure, solenoid pressure.
Okay.
Okay. I showed you the safety activation switch
yeah.
and how light the pull. The trigger's fully adjustable, pre-travel, post-travel, and the amount of force it takes to fire.
Okay.
Most people will want a very, at least bench shooters will want a very minimum force.
Sure.
And that's where that actuation switch comes into play.
But then you can set that to where it stays on or turns off after a certain
that's,
amount of time.
That's
or,
right.
What, okay.
That's right. The regulator itself, the most important aspect, is you can turn it up and down without having to degas your gun.
Yeah, which is.
Which makes a big difference.
Yeah, huge. Especially in tournament time
right.
and when you're.
This one's designed for travel, so it's very easy to bleed the gun and take off the tank and show people that it's empty.
Okay.
We also will and have in the works future mod where you can add in actual valves in here.
Into the bottle.
So you can have extra bottles if you want pressurized.
Okay.
And for certain types of shooters, we'll probably put a regulator in there because if I'm shooting, for example, I love the long 30 caliber. That's what I love to shoot
yeah.
with this gun. I'm at 1,100 pounds in the chamber to shoot that. That's 73 bar.
Yeah.
And, you know,
73
so
bar.
I don't
so
need
low.
To bring 45. Yeah, I know. I don't need to bring 4,500 PSI into that to get my velocity. I only
right.
need 1,100.
Right.
So if I put a regulator in here and bring my pressure in 2,000,
yeah.
my standard deviation fluctuation will be almost unbelievable.
Sure.
Because I'll shoot it down from, it'll never see more than 2,000 into the chamber, and I'll only shoot it from full pressure down to probably 1,500 before I refill.
Which just puts less wear and tear on the inner parts of the gun.
Well, and it makes it very, so this regulator, which is very capable of regulating 4,500 pounds,
yeah,
very consistently, but when you bring a constant pressure into it, it just gets ridiculous.
Sure.
So, you know, so.
Man, you thought of everything.
We tried to think of a lot. It's hard, a lot of work. And then we got, you know, you're getting, you ask why is the gun is $2,950 and you wonder what you're getting.
Well, yeah.
Remember, you're getting the carbon fiber sleeves, the three sets of barrels with the one size, three different sizes, with the liners already on them for rigidity.
Yeah.
You got a sturdy upper chassis.
Yeah.
With M-lock.
Very beefy.
A very adjustable situation with your cheek and your shoulder.
Yeah.
You know, we're bringing a lot of the accessories you might have to go out and buy for a gun are already there.
Sure.
Forget the fact that the valve's completely unique as a whole package.
Yeah.
Break it down, it's very competitive.
Amazing. Are these yours, or are these, you know, I'm seeing you have the bottle clamp here. These are parts.
These are parts, but
okay.
And there's people do ask because they want to know how we're going to do this without going to the bottle. Right?
Sure.
And what we're doing is we're doing an extrusion that comes off the MLAP. It comes down.
Okay.
Around the bottom and allows for your Weaver mount under here.
Oh, gotcha.
So that's in the works. That'll allow you to use your, you know, the really high end bipods and such that everyone wants to use.
What do you call this gun?
The EPOCH.
The EPOCH.
If you have any questions,
I mean,
when you turn it on, it'll tell you.
Literally, when you turn the gun on, it says, "Welcome to the EPOCH experience."
Yes.
Like you can actually hear it. Bill, this is insane, man. You've thought of everything. I can't wait to. I mean, these are shipping right now, right?
Yep,
people right now can
30
go.
30 caliber is shipping. 25 will follow.
Okay. 30 caliber just in time for tournament.
7
tournament
will follow
time.
That very
okay.
soon.
But you're going 30, 35.
Actually.
177?
Yeah, and then right after that, or so. So we're also 357 is really close.
Okay.
Let me tell you a couple things about how they come. So 177 really doesn't require a 35 inch barrel.
Sure.
So we're going to ship that in a 25-inch barrel,
okay.
And we're not sure we're going to make a 35-inch because it doesn't make a lot of sense. You don't need it.
Right.
22, 25, and 30 will come in the 25-inch barrel, and the accessory barrel for 35 will be available.
Okay.
35 caliber, 81 grain, typically requires so much energy that we don't recommend the short barrel. It'll shoot well, but you have to turn your pressure up a good bit.
Sure.
So we ship that with the 35-inch barrel, which allows you to still get a great tune at around 1,500 PSI, push maybe 900 feet per second out of a 35 caliber, which is a lot of, you know, 145 foot-pounds, 144 foot-pounds.
Sure.
And so that's how they'll initially start. And the 22 will, strangely enough, will probably be the last. And that's not by design. That's because we did do a lot of work on the 22 caliber barrels to get them right.
Go to scoutairguns.com?
Yep.
That's where, right now, shipping, selling.
And we have Instagram and Facebook and all the, you know.
Okay.
All the other.
And then where do these designs, can anyone pick?
Well, our idea, the gold gun.
The gold gun.
The gold gun.
The golden gun.
Anyone.
You're going to gift that to me right now. I cannot, not see this coming.
Well, you can get it. You just have to earn it. Let me tell you how. So, for those who wish to compete with our EPOCH in the major events, the person who scores within the top 10 and is the highest using the EPOCH gets the golden EPOCH.
Gets the golden EPOCH. So if you buy this gun,
shoot it
in a competition,
and
you got to get top 10.
Yep.
But
you
if you're
be,
the...
You have to be the top. So if there's three guys that get in, you're the top performer.
If you're the top performer, you get
this
gun.
The golden gun. Yeah. Yeah.
The big the big ones, we're talking, I'm imagining Pyramid Air Cup, RMAC, and
EBR.
Okay.
So, on top of that, these colors are not hard for us to do. We've been doing it for years.
Yeah.
So, the dealers will actually be able to get these guns in colors eventually. Now, remember, guys, we're shipping in black right now. It's brand new, but this is not difficult for us to do.
Okay.
And then we have some really specialized colors, which will come down the line.
Sure. Man. And everything you guys do, you do it in house, you make the parts, you machine. I mean, this is everything, you make everything?
Let's clarify that.
Okay, yeah.
We machine, we design, engineer, and assemble everything.
Okay.
We have our own in-house prototyping shop, Integrex's five-axis mills, where we make every single part.
Okay.
But we own a second company that we own and run.
Yeah.
actually Adam's the president, in Taiwan,
okay,
where we manufacture the rest of the product in volume. So it's all American owned,
yeah,
but it is not all produced in the United States in terms of the parts.
Sure, but you guys control everything.
We do, it's all.
Which makes it much easier to
every employee,
grow from here.
Every employee that does anything with it is our employee, and is and the company is an American owned company.
I don't know what else you guys want to hear. This has been a very long video, but this is a very complex gun that needs to be discussed. You've thought of everything. I can't wait to get this on the range and start shooting it. But I mean, this looks like a great little hunting gun. I mean, right, with the shorter barrel at 30 cal, I mean, for hogs or coyotes or, I just gotta hold this thing. I mean, see, I will tell you, it's girthy, right?
It
it's a beefy gun for sure.
The gun
feels
without,
good.
The gun without any, this gun without any of the, with the scope and without the, it's just at 10 pounds.
10 pounds.
Yeah.
Balanced, feels good in your hand, looks good. Man, well done, gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Are you ready to launch this year?
We are. We're launched.
It's everything's going to order right
one,
now.
You can order 30 caliber right now.
Right now. Right now. Don't right now. And then you have a chance to win the golden gun. Tournament time's coming, baby. The first one is in a couple months, so you people better get ready. Bill?
All right, thank you.
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you.
One year, a lot's happened.
It has.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You heard it here first. Guys, check them out. Skout with a K. ScoutAirguns.com. Get them while they're hot.